Hello everyone, welcome back to the next lecture in the computer network series, and today we will see the basics of Cisco Packet Tracer part 2. In part 2, we will be mainly focusing on hubs. We will see the outcomes of today's session now. In today's session, we are going to know the basics of Cisco Packet Tracer, know about hubs, and we will simulate a local area network using hub. And finally, we will understand the pros and cons of hub. We will see what is a hub. A hub, it is also known as a network hub. And this hub works at the physical layer of the OSI model. We know that there are 7 layers in the OSI model, and hub is a device that works in the physical layer, that is layer 1. And this hub is used to set up a local area network, and we know that local area network means it is restricted to a small geographic area. Maybe an office network or a school network can be a local area network. And if we want to connect some devices in a local area network, we need a central device like hub or a switch. In this lecture, we are focusing on hubs. And if we want to connect some devices using hubs, we need that device with multiple ports. So hub has multiple ports. We will see an example now. It will be more clear for you. Suppose if this is the hub, then this hub has multiple ports. Suppose if I want to connect 10 computers, yes, I can connect 10 computers through this hub because I have 10 ports in this hub. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So I can establish 10 computers as a local area network through this hub. If I have 20 computers, no worries, bring another hub, connect these two hubs and extend your network accordingly. We have a serious drawback with hubs. We will see what is that in the upcoming slides. And the local area network that we form using hub will be coming under star topology. We have already seen star topology in the previous lecture. In star topology, there will be a central administration like hub or switch, and this is used to connect all the devices. So hub comes under star topology. And we will see what is the working principle of hub now. When a packet arrives at one port, very important, when a packet arrives at one port, it is copied to other ports so that all segments of the LAN can see all packets. For example, if there are 10 ports in a hub and if some computer is sending a packet in one port, then that data is copied in all the remaining 9 ports. If there are 10 ports in a hub, if one computer is connected to one of the ports and if that port is receiving an incoming packet and that packet is forwarded to the remaining 9 ports of the hub. This is the working principle of a hub. If you don't understand anything out of this point, we will see the working of hub, then this point will be clear for you. We will now see the working principle of a hub. If this is the hub and we have a computer and let's assume that this computer is connected to this port and this is the cable that is used to connect this computer and a hub. Now we will recollect what cable should be used in order to connect a computer and a hub. Since computer and hub are different devices, so we need to use Ethernet straight through cable. So normally Ethernet straight through cable is used to connect this computer and a hub. Now, let's assume this computer is somehow connected with this hub. Now if this computer wants to send some data, now this data is actually sent to this port. Now what this hub does? This hub copies this information to all the remaining 9 ports of the hub. So this is what the working principle of a hub. We will revisit the working of hub again. Suppose if this computer wants to send some data to some other computer which is connected to some ports of this hub, what this computer does, this computer sends the data to this port. Now this is the port that receives this packet. Now what this hub does, this hub copies this data to all the other ports of the hub. So this hub copies the data to all the other ports of the hub and all the devices that are connected to the hub will receive a copy. Whether they need the data or not, in a hub, every data is broadcast to all the nodes in the network. This is what the drawback of a hub. Now we will see the working of hub using Cisco Packet Tracer. We will now see how to create a local area network using Hub in Cisco Packet Tracer. CPT means Cisco Packet Tracer. So I will open Cisco Packet Tracer. I will go on to the Hub section and let me choose the Hub. I'll click on the Hub and click on the workspace. So I have brought in the Hub. Let me click on this Hub and let me see what is there in the Hub. How many ports are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So there are 6 ports in my Hub. So I can connect 6 devices. So let me close this. So I will bring 6 PCs here. So let me click on the end devices part and let me click on the PCs. So I will bring 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So I need to connect cable. So this is the cable section which we had already seen in the previous lecture. So click on the cable. We need straight through cable. So click on the straight through cable. Connect the fast Ethernet port to the port 0. Similarly, take another cable from fast Ethernet port 0 to port 1. So fast Ethernet 0 to port 2. I am connecting all the computers with the cable. I hope now you can see local area network is established. So press escape to release this cursor. Okay, now cable section is over. Now you could notice that I have brought in a hub and I have brought in 6 PCs. So all the 6 PCs are connected to the 6 ports. It means all the 6 PCs are connected to all the 6 ports. If you observe, it is in green color. Green color means it is ready for data communication. You could also observe that this is the button that is used to turn on or off the hub. So I'll just click on it. You could notice that the hub is turned off now. I will just turn it on by just clicking on the button. Yeah, now the hub is turned on. In order to establish communication among the computers, we are required to assign IP addresses to all the computers. What we are required to do now is we will go to every PC and assign IP address to all the PCs. So let me click on this PC and go to the desktop section. Click on the IP configuration and let me give 10.10.10.1. So 10.10.10.1 is the IP address that I am assigning for the first computer. So let me go on to the second PC and I will assign the IP address as 10.10.10.2 to the second computer. And let me assign 10.10.10.3 to the third computer. So 10.10.10.3 is the IP address that I am assigning for the third computer. For the fourth computer, the IP address is going to be 10.10.10.4. And for the fifth computer, the IP address is going to be 10.10.10.5. And finally, I'm assigning 10.10.10.6 to the last computer, 10.10.10.6. So I have completed assigning the IP address to all the PCs. Now let's check whether I am able to communicate with each other. So let me go on to the third PC. We will now check what is the IP address of third PC. Go to the PC, command prompt and give IP config. Yeah, it says 10.10.10.3 is the IP address of this computer. So from this computer, we will try pinging this computer. It is 10.10.10.6. Let me go on to the command prompt of this PC and give ping 10.10.10.6, that is the IP address of the destination computer. Yeah, we are able to get reply. It means these two computers are able to communicate with each other. So far, we have established a local area network. Now, to understand the working principle of Hub, instead of being in the real-time mode, we will now move on to the simulation mode. So just click on this, which is the simulation mode. And let me close this here. Now we are in the simulation mode. You could notice that now we are in the simulation mode. So let me send a packet from this PC to this PC. For example, this is the simple PDU. So I'll click on this packet. Click on the first computer. It means this is the source computer. And click on this computer and this is the destination computer. Now you could notice that it is in process because we are in simulation mode. Now let me click on the capture bar forward button. Now the packet is received by the hub. Now we know that this PC is connected to this port and we have other 5 ports are connected to other 5 computers. We will see what this hub does after receiving that packet. Now this hub is forwarding the data to all the ports. That is what we have seen in the working principle part. But this packet is actually intended to this guy or to this computer. And that is why this computer is accepting that packet and other computers are rejecting that packet. Now when this computer wants to give acknowledgement and this reply is also sent to the hub, what the hub does, again it forwards the entire data to all the ports except the one that it has sent. Now all the ports, all the computers are denying this packet except this port. Why? Because this needs the acknowledgement. So this is what the working principle of hub. Let me delete this packet and let me check whether it works fine for the second attempt also. So let this be the same source and let this be the same destination. Let me send a packet now. Yeah, hub receives this packet and let me click on this packet and see. And we know that this hub is a device that works in only layer 1. And that is why it is showing in the OAC reference model part that it is a device that is working in layer 1. Now, when I click capture bar forward, we are able to see that this hub is broadcasting the data to all the ports except the one which has sent. And others are denying because the packet is not intended for them. And this guy only is accepting that packet. And when it wants to send an acknowledgement, just click on the capture bar forward. Now the acknowledgement is received. So this computer has sent the data through this port and the hub, it will forward the data to all the other ports except the one which has sent. And other guys will deny that packet except the sender and the receiver. So this is what the working principle of a hub. There is always a serious problem with broadcasting. If there are 100 computers or 500 computers or 1000 computers, this broadcast floods the entire network. And that is this problem with hubs. We know that the communication is successful and we have established a local area network using a hub. So far we have seen how to create a local area network using hub in Cisco Packet Tracer. Now we will see the pros and cons of hubs. Hubs. The pros, the positives about hub are, it is cheaper than switches. So in terms of price, hubs are always cheaper than switches. And it works good for smaller network, but when it is a big network, hubs will definitely create problems with broadcasting. And we have serious drawbacks with hubs. And the cons are, there are always issues with broadcast and hub has no memory. Whatever it receives in one port, that will be forwarded to other ports. And it will not store anything. It has no memory, so it will not store any information. So we can say hubs are not an intelligent device. And finally, hubs normally runs in half duplex mode. It means it can send data as well as it can receive data, but not both at the same time. Because of these drawbacks only, we are moving from hubs to switches. So switches are completely dominating today's contemporary world and hubs are not using predominantly. And that's it guys. I hope now you are clear with the basics of Cisco Packet Tracer to some extent. And we know about hubs and we simulated a local area network using hub and we understood the pros and cons of hub. I hope the session is informative and thank you for watching.